All right, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how we can find second, third, fourth, or whatever match you want from a list of matches. And we should be able to do this on both Google Sheets and Excel, assuming you have the version of Excel that has the functions that we need. If you look here, I have this list of contacts, and we should be able to find this company ID in this first column more than once. So if I just go ahead and copy one of these and just search, see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are different contacts from the same company, and the company ID is right here. I'm gonna show you how we can find the second match or the third or the fourth or the nth match, basically from a list of matches. Now, if you're trying to find the first match, you would use a VLOOKUP. If you're trying to find all of the matches, I have a video covering that. But in this one, let's say you just wanted to get the second or the third, something like that. So to do that, let's go to this company's list, and we should have a company ID here or a company number. So if I was searching for this number, for example, in this contacts, see there's 1, there's 2. Apparently there's only 2 for those. So if I'm trying to find the second match, what I would do, I would go back here. And what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna do a function called filter. So I'm gonna do equals filter. And here we need to provide a range. So that range is going to be what you need returned after you find the match. So that means if we, for example, search and find this is that match, right? Do we want to then get the results from this names column, email column, or department, or what is it gonna be? So let's for right now assume we're gonna get the name. So what I would do in that case, I would just select this list of names. Now, in Google Sheets, I can just drop the end reference like this. In Excel, you wouldn't be able to do that. So you could just go for the whole column like this. Let's make it compatible for both. So I'm just gonna select this whole column B. In this case, that's names, comma. Before doing comma, let's actually do F4 for good practice to make it absolute reference, comma. And then I want what's called a condition. So this condition should be an array of trues and falses. And we can get that array by selecting this IDs. And again, I'm gonna do F4 for absolute reference for this. And then I'm gonna do equals. So I want the IDs that match. I'll go back to companies and click on this first company ID, which is in this A2 cell. So if I close parentheses and I hit enter, see what this function is gonna return is the list of names from here that match that ID. So if I just go and search for this ID right here. See, we have these two matches and these are their names. See, we have Wesley, we have this guy. So if we go back and take a look, here they are, both. Now, I want, in this case, the second match, which is this. So what I would do, I would just go back here and put this filter function inside of index function, like this. And index function will allow us to select the position from which we want to get the results. So I want the second one, so I'm gonna do 2. So this should return the person we actually want. So see, the second match would be this one. Now, if I wanted to get the first match, then instead of 2, I could do 1. Now, for the first match, you could also do a VLOOKUP instead of doing all of this. But see, it will work. And then you can just change this to any number you want, right? So if you wanted like the third match, you would do 3. And I don't think we had a third match for this. So see, we get an error because there's no third match. At this point, if I just take this formula the way it is and just drag it down, we should be able to see third matches wherever they are available. So for example, for this one, if we go check, that should be Chase. So let's go and take a look. First, second, and third, see, that's Chase, so that's what we got. And let's just check one more, so let's take a look at this one, and that should be Marvin, so let's go back and take a look. So 1, 2, 3, and third one is Marvin. As you can see, works just fine. And if you wanted to handle those errors, then we can just take this and put this inside of if error function like this and close parentheses in the end. So basically what this is going to do, if it's an error, it's just going to leave it blank. So if I wanted to get the second match, then I can change this to 2, the index, and drag this down. And that should give us all second matches if they're available. So that's that. Now, this same function should be possible in Excel with one difference. So the last piece I did here for if error, Excel doesn't allow you to do optional if error here. In this case, what I did in Google Sheets, I just skipped this value if error and basically just leave it blank. In Excel, you can do that. So what you can do here, you can do comma and do double quotes to just leave it blank. And that should work in Google Sheets as well. Just like that. Let's just test the same formula in Excel to verify that it works. So I'm going to copy this, hit escape, go back to Excel. So the same file we had from there, I'll just go ahead and paste right in here and hit enter and drag it down. See, same formula works in Excel and Google Sheets to get us the second or whatever match you like. In this case, second, you can change it to, again, 3 to get the third match if it's available, like that, and so on. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.